Hello everyone, I'm Monica Bhushan and today we are going to discuss the application of matrix in our daily life. Okay, so we have read many places that matrices are applied in mathematics, computer graphics, image processing, artificial intelligence and many more places, fine. But in today's session, we are going to discuss the very simple examples where we knowingly or unknowingly apply matrix in our day-to-day life. Okay, so sometimes when we think of what we have to do today, that is the application of matrix. Sometimes unknowingly, we use matrix to even solve our confusion, to solve any calculation. Okay, so I'm just going to give you one simple example where we use matrix to solve daily problem. Just giving you one example that maybe I want to keep fish tank in my home. For that, I wanted to buy 5 fishes of different species. Okay, and then I want to keep it in my home. Okay, for that, I went to the aquarium shop and there I just picked 5 fishes. Maybe I picked angel fish. Okay, then I decided to buy one barb fish also, then gold fish also, very beautiful fish, fine. Then I thought to keep one big fish which is Oscar and then the small, very small fish which is tetra, okay, fine. But the shopkeeper actually said me that I cannot buy these 5 fishes together to keep in one fish tank, okay. Shopkeeper said that angel fishes can live together, that means angel fish can live with angel fish can live with barb fish, fine, but with gold fish I'm not advised to keep this angel fish, even not with Oscar fish also, and then angel fish can live with tetra also. Okay, then he said that if I'm going to buy the barb fish, so barb fish is compatible with this angel fish also, fine, and barb fish can live with barb fish also, but barb fish cannot live with gold fish. Okay, so these many things he is just giving me information, and then he is saying that even with Oscar I cannot keep barb fish, and even barb will not go with tetra also. Okay, then what about the goldfish? So as he said that goldfish cannot live with angel fish, goldfish cannot live with even barb fish, fine. And then with Oscar also, this is big no. Even with tetra also, I should not keep goldfish. So eventually I came to know that goldfish is compatible with goldfish only among these many species. And then I came to know that Oscar fishes are the fighter fishes. We cannot keep Oscar with tetra, which is very small. Oscar can eat tetra and so on, fine. So Oscar with everybody else, it is big no. And then I came to know that tetra will go with angel fish. I can keep all 5 tetra. So these many things, if somebody is telling me, I'm just going to get confused that what I have to do or what not I have to do, fine. So these confusions and these many calculations can be avoided using matrix. And what I'll do, I'll write systematically about different fishes. So I'll dedicate one vertical line for one species of fish, which in our mathematical way, we say that one variable. Another vertical line will be called as another variable. Similarly, one for goldfish, one for Oscar, one for tetra. How many fishes I just wanted to keep, I am going to write down differently in one dedicated column. Fine. So same thing I'm just going to write in this chart. Now I'm just going to write down whether angel fish and angel fish. If yes, then I'm just going to write down one here. Okay. Then I'll say that whether angel fish and barb, yes, then I'll write down one. If it is no for goldfish, I'll write down 0. No for Oscar, I'll write down 0. If yes for tetra, I'll write down 1. Okay, what about my barb fish? So I'm taking information of only barb for this line. So if angel fish can live with barb, that means barb can live with angel fish. This is adjacency matrix, okay? Even barb and barb can live. But I said that no for all other species, fine? So I'm just writing down zeros here. Similarly, I'm writing down about goldfish, I'm writing down about Oscar, I'm writing down about tetra. I'm just mapping whatever is said to me in column and row fashion, okay? So after mapping, I can see that things are getting much more clear also. And then I can do mini observation using these rows and columns, fine? So here is the mapping completed. So this mathematical mapping is basically the matrix where these columns I'm going to use and these rows I'm going to use. And in mathematical language, we say that these many different species, what I'm using here, they are nothing but different variables, okay? And I'm writing down the relation between different variables in one place using just zeros and ones. And if I have to decide with these things, it is going to be very difficult, very confusing. But if I look at this mathematical place, I'll come to know that which all fishes I can put together. Even many different characteristics also I'll come to know that if I want to keep Oscar because they are bigger in size, for that I have to keep all five Oscars together, fine. And I can find this observation that all fishes are compatible with them. That means five angel fishes, five bar, five goldfish, five Oscar, five tetra, or maybe two angel fishes, two bar fishes and one tetra can be done without confusion and without wasting too much of time, fine. This is one example of the matrix, fine. So this is what? This is 5x5 matrix, okay? Where you can find that this is the principal diagonal where you can see that all ones are present, fine. And many more observations even we can do using this matrix form. And similarly, one other scenario if I'll give where unknowingly you use matrix to decide something is, suppose in your college you have given some textbook to your friend and then the very next day when you have asked about your textbook, then your friend said that the textbook is not with him, fine. His some other friend has taken from him. So what you will do, instead of checking with each and every person who are present in your classroom, you will just think that who all are closer to your friend, okay? And then you will save your time by checking them first. Similarly, suppose you are just going to do your breakfast, fine, and you wanted to have milk with cornflakes and you found that milk is not there. So which all combinations you can make with cornflakes, maybe you have honey or something else. So these all things we do in our mind, unknowingly they are nothing but the application of matrix only. Even you can think of many more applications of matrix which you really use in your day-to-day life. Okay, so if you find this class useful, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.